Okay, hello and welcome to the podcast. This will be our Godzilla podcast. I don't know if we're going to be doing this again. Depends. With me is my brother Aiden.
Move. I'm the person who knows about Godzilla. You
You're
talk
up.
about FNAF.
Yeah, I do. Anyway.
Yuna, say hello. Say hello. Come on, kitty. Say hello. Yes, I know.
Right. So, yeah. First of all, March 31st, Godzilla vs. Kong dropped. First of all, what's your opinion on that?
Me?
Yeah, what do you think?
Oh, well, it was good.
Yeah, I agree. But let's go into a bit more detail.
How?
What things did you like? Obviously, it was nice that all the fights were in day, first of all.
Yeah, and
Yeah.
then the I liked Mechagodzilla,
Yeah,
and
Mechagodzilla.
Warbats are cool new kaiju.
Yeah, I still don't get the name Warbat though. It's like
Well, its other name is Nozuki.
Nozuki, yeah, I suppose. But fits better, but anyway,
No, it
honestly,
doesn't.
I mean, it sounds Japanese, kind of. Probably is. Yeah,
Who knows?
sorry.
And now there's someone at the door.
It doesn't matter. It's not
I'll be
hearable.
right back.
Anyway, so
Okay.
What were we talking about?
Godzilla.
Yeah, but I think we were
Godzilla
talking about
versus.
Mecha Godzilla and
We were
Nozuki and
talking
stuff.
about. It's Warbat.
Okay, fine. Anyway, yeah. So, first of all, who do you think won? Because it wasn't entirely
It
spelled
is
out.
it's pretty much entirely clear.
Yeah, it's
There
pretty
were
clear.
two fights between Godzilla and Kong in the movie,
And
and
Godzilla
Godzilla
won
won
both
both of
of them.
them,
Yeah, but
and it left Kong pretty much on the brink of death after the second fight and almost drowning in the first one.
Obviously
And
this.
I've like saw this YouTube video like parody thing as this guy was like is like imitating like the people who thought Kong were going to win, and they're like, technically it's a draw because like Kong struck the finishing blow against Mechagodzilla and Godzilla beat Kong, so it's a draw. And that just doesn't make any
No,
sense.
it doesn't.
And
I mean, it kind of makes
the
sense, but it's like the
no
movie's
no no
called
it
Godzilla
doesn't.
vs. Kong. The winner is the one who won that fight. Yeah.
Stuff.
Stuff. Now we've got our basic thoughts out on the movie. The next thing would obviously be, what do you think is going to be set up? We've talked about this, off camera, but I'm going to basically set up my main theory. We're gonna do theories. My main theory is Mechagodzilla's pieces, at least most of them, are still in Hong Kong, right? His
Well,
head.
no, Monarch probably took them, or
Yeah.
someone obviously took them. They aren't just going to leave the remnants of a giant robot that almost killed Godzilla and Kong
Yeah.
sitting in the middle of a city where literally anyone could just take them.
Okay, fine. The parts aren't even really that important for this, but the point is now the Hollow Earth has been introduced, right?
Yeah, and Godzilla, using his atomic breath, has dug a hole directly into it, which means now people can get into the Hollow Earth without using the heaves or Hollow Earth exploration vehicle thingies, because now there's just a straight hole that doesn't involve light speed warps or whatever.
Yeah.
That was a major plot point in the movie. They can't get in there
There's just
without the vehicles because they'd be crushed by super speed
So
gravity
yeah,
or whatever.
now that anyone can get into it. And in the Hollow Earth, we've been introduced to stuff like Warbats, that weird blizzard thing that the fandom's calling Duog, Dog,
Doug,
Dog.
what? It's pronounced Doug.
I
Why?
don't know. I don't know. I just look at how things are spelt.
Yeah.
Anyway, but and then
Well,
there's the
that's how
express.
Doug's spelt.
There's an A in there. Anyway, but anyway.
There's no A in Doug.
It is spelt.
No, the creature's name is not.
That's how it was spelt.
No, that's Dwag.
Okay, whatever. The.
It's spelt like that. Hold on, I'm gonna search up on Wikizilla's Hollow Earth page. It lists its name.
Yeah, you just do that. Yeah.
Actual name is blah blah blah. Let's see.
Warbat
Yeah, it
Hong
mentions warbats and stuff.
Kong.
Hold on. Finn, why do you have to talk directly into my ear? Here we go. It's called a photodon. It was originally introduced in some other King, in the Peter Jackson King Kong movie, where it played a much bigger role than to eat an arachnoclaw, which is what the little spider creatures are called.
Anyway, so yeah.
And there are all kinds of creatures that live in the Hollow Earth. After Kingdom Kong, Kamazots got thrown back into the Hollow Earth, and as far as we know, he's still alive and just down in the Hollow Earth waiting for it to be dark outside so he can come out, because apparently he's vulnerable to light.
Well, that must suck. Anyway.
He's a bat.
He's a bat, but like still, it must suck.
Not entirely sure how that works. Also, the Hollow Earth is apparently, according to the trivia section on Wikizilla's page about it, is a real hypothesis stating that the Earth is entirely hollow or has an inner space, though it has long been discredited.
Yeah, so it's a real theory.
Yeah, well, it was. Was,
yeah. So yeah, the point is, anyway, I like to get off topic, but this is...
As far as we know, though,
never mind.
The only Titans that... to have been introduced in Hollow Earth are Kong, who went there after Godzilla vs. Kong, yeah. The Warbats, which there are probably more of, yeah. And Kamazots.
Yeah.
Tiamat was in the Hollow Earth in Godzilla Dominion, but then it left after fighting Godzilla. And the rest are all Titan subspecies.
Anyway, so yeah. I like to get off topic, but this is too much off topic. Back to the theory. So yeah, now that anyone can get into the Hollow Earth, let's like this give either Kong. I think Kong is more likely. Like either Kong or Godzilla ends up beating a kaiju, right? That kaiju gets wounded. That kaiju gets picked up by like whatever is left of Apex or some other evil organization.
Oh yeah, there's probably gonna be a new evil organization.
Yeah, and then like. They take that kaiju, they rebuild it using the pieces of Mechagodzilla, or just new pieces.
And then it becomes Gigan.
It becomes Gigan, yes. That's like the most logical way I could see Gigan being introduced. Yeah.
There have also been hints and teases for kaiju like Destroyer from the Oxygen Destroyer in King of Monsters, and Biollante when it met in a newspaper article in the end credits, where a person who mentioned that Monarch was building a mechanized Titan on Skull Island, which was wrong, but it also said that they were creating a biologically creating a Titan, which hints at Biollante.
Yeah.
Or maybe Hedorah, because in the anime trilogy, Hedorah is a human bioweapon.
You're right. But, like, hold up.
That went on a rampage and destroyed multiple cities.
Right, so, like, that newspaper article thinks that Monarch is building it. And if you watch the movie, you watch Godzilla vs. Kong, there's no evidence that Apex created Mechagodzilla.
Yes,
at least to the public. To the public.
Yeah, to the public, yeah.
So they might think it's Monarch. They might end up thinking that Monarch made Mechagodzilla.
Like, look, here, there's an image. In Godzilla Dominion, Godzilla swims past the corpses of a bunch of dead Titans. We've got one that might be, another member of Yamato no Orochi species, because it's got, like, all these heads. That one kind of looks like a Bionicle character's head.
Yeah, it kind of does.
And then that thing's, I don't know what that is, or that. But they're just a bunch of weird-looking stuff there.
Yeah.
And so, then there are all kind of, I'm hoping King Ghidorah will return in some form.
Yeah.
Though at this point it's his skull, definitely something's gonna happen to it. Either Monarch took it or like what's left of Apex or something.
Yeah.
But his skull is probably going to appear later again. I just hope it actually ends up being used for something.
So, the Monsters is pretty clearly gonna continue, right? Godzilla vs. Kong was, like, the only film of 2021, and it did pretty well.
Yeah.
Did better than King of Monsters, but that's not saying much.
King of Monsters, I think, was good. But
I thought it was good, but...
apparently just, not many people shared my...
Not many people went to see it, is the problem. There was a ton of other movies coming out.
That's McGarger, from what I was telling you about before.
Yeah, I know. Not set photo, like... Or not set photo, but, like...
It's, just a photo of McGarger. And here's Kraken.
Yeah.
That's what Kraken actually looks like. Essentially, in Godzilla Dominion, Godzilla, like, after doing a bunch of stuff across the globe and fighting some monsters. Godzilla tells all the other titans to go back into rest. I'm pretty sure Behemoth was in the Amazon, because that's where he was when we saw him last in the comic. And Rodan, we know, nested in some new volcano that I can't remember where it was. But the rest, we don't know where they are. And there are a bunch of titans that we haven't seen yet. Like, we, in the novelization for King of Monsters, we got to see a bunch of descriptions and stuff about Mokele Membe.
Yeah.
And he's described as being, like, a skeletal, no, like a sauropod dinosaur with an elephant-like face, crocodile mouth, tusks that curve downwards, and a big horn on the top of his head that pulses with a faint green light. I have gotten this information entirely from Wikizilla.
I mean, we have the book.
Well, yeah. Yes, but I saw it first on Wikizilla.
You saw it first, anyway.
Okay, so, yeah, there are all kinds of the titans and stuff. And let's see, there's Abaddon, Amluk, who we've been revealed, Bahomet,
okay, so that's
Behemoth, who was also revealed. He attacked, like, Rio de Janeiro or something like that, and is probably the most popular of them.
Of course.
Bunyip.
Kraken.
It was Kraken, or Na'kika, as he's called in Godzilla Dominion.
Mm-hmm.
Then there's Leviathan, who came from Loch Ness, which is interesting. So now that we've got Tiamat's design revealed as similar to, like, similar to Manda from the original Godzilla
and
series.
Kraken.
I'm assuming that if Leviathan's design ever gets revealed, it'll be more like a plesiosaur. And
maybe it's Titanosaurus. Maybe it's like a Titanosaurus-looking like thing.
Maybe. But then it would be called Titanosaurus.
Yeah, but Titanosaurus has a copyright, so you can't necessarily use that.
And Methuselah. Then there's also Methuselah, who's in Munich, Germany.
Yeah.
Mokele Membe, who we got described. And if this thing had video, I would show you the art Wikizilla used in their video. Right there.
Yeah, I'll probably edit it in or something.
Come on, zoom out. Yeah, that's like the description of Mokele Membe, what he looks like.
Yeah.
There's also Quetzalcoatl.
Which is probably like a
pterosaur. Scylla.
Yeah, Scylla. Spider-Man.
Sekhmet.
No clue what that could be.
Typhon,
yeah.
Yamato no Orochi, has been confirmed, and like he's confirmed to have 8 heads by the director, which makes me think he'll probably look something like he does in Orochi the Eight-Headed Dragon, the Toho film. There are also some other unseen titans, and there was a titan that was cut from the movie Sargon in Mexico. No idea what he looked like or what he would have done. And then there's also some designs for titans, like a scorpion and a weird Muto-like creature, kind of, and a weird tentacle monster.
Yeah.
And there was originally going to be a bunch of classic Toho monsters in the movie, like Gigan, Kamacarus, Baragon, Angarus, Gamera. Even Gamera. But then they found out that Toho charges a different price tag for every single creature, so they decided it wasn't worth it.
It's a real shame, because I would have.
But
really
there
liked
is
Gamera.
A skeleton of what may or may not be Angarus, seen in the scene where Godzilla's lair is destroyed.
Mm. It is Angarus, but the director's just going, it may or may not be, so he doesn't get copyrighted.
Yeah, because Angarus has copyright, so they can't say it's Angarus.
Yeah, so.
Yeah. And then there are all sorts of sub-titans, like the Hellhawks, Arachnoclaws, Photodon, Skullcrawlers
I was about to ask, are Skullcrawlers sub-titans?
And then there's this big fish thing from Godzilla Dominion called Genitor.
Oh, yeah.
And he's got like, he has a swarm of little piranha-like minions.
Yeah. Pretty weird.
They attack Godzilla at his old lair that was blown up.
Of course. Yeah.
And then, like, I'm assuming, like, at this point, Monarch probably has the corpse. We know Monarch has the corpses of the first two Mutos and Muto Prime.
Yep.
And now, after this, after, like, Godzilla vs. Kong, they probably have Warbat's corpse, potentially King Ghidorah's skull, and the Mechagodzilla remains.
Probably.
Yeah, they probably got to it first. And then they've probably got, like, some dead skull crawlers, like, Apex genetically modified skull crawlers to be much larger, so they could test Mechagodzilla with them, because, like, skull crawlers are, the regular size skull crawlers are only, like, a tenth of Mechagodzilla's size,
yeah,
and like, the big one, or the Skull Devil, as it's called in the novelization, is only, like, Kong's size, and Kong is, like, a fourth of the size of Mechagodzilla.
Or he was.
So, or something like that, yeah. Yeah. So, they had to make them bigger, or it just wouldn't work.
Yeah. So, yeah. It's interesting how they did the Hollow Earth, because, like, I remember we were theorizing before we got any, like, trailers that the shots of Warbat in the Hollow Earth, like, they'd just be Peeves in, like, dark tunnels with Warbat.
Yeah, that's what I imagined it
as. Yeah, me too.
Just, like, big stony tunnels, and they would be attacked by Warbats and Skullcrawlers as they went through there. But it actually ended up being this lush, thriving ecosystem filled with all sorts of creatures. Mothra has been confirmed to have laid her egg in China by the director, and it was found by Monarch. We know that by the newspaper and the end credits. Mm. But it has yet to hatch, so we haven't seen Mothra return yet, so hopefully she will return.
Yeah. Well, so yeah. Yeah, they've set up a lot. Like, it was a pretty risky move to set up so much stuff with King of Monsters, considering that movie didn't do that well in the box office, and they set up so much. They set up, like, Mechanical Titans, Bio Titans, Mothra's Egg, Alan Jonah, who just got stepped on.
Yeah, according to the director, Alan Jonah, his official death is Godzilla stomped on him in between movies.
Yeah. Oh.
So we've got that whole epic end credit scene of Godzilla verse. Godzilla King of Monsters, and then we never see him again because he just died in between movies. I hope we get, like, a comic or something that shows us what happens, at least.
Yeah.
So we at least get to see what happened to
him. Yeah, that'd be nice. So, yeah, honestly, like, what movie do you think it's going to be next? Do you think it's going to be a Kong or Godzilla movie?
I feel like it's probably going to be a Kong movie, but I hope it's a Godzilla movie, because the Godzilla movie would just be more interesting.
Yeah,
Kong is just not that interesting.
Yeah, he's not a big Kong fan. I like Kong a lot. I think, honestly, I'd like both.
Crazy.
I'd like both, honestly. Either movie is fine. It's kind of like with me with Godzilla vs. Kong. It's like, I wanted Kong to win, but I was fine with the result that Kong lost. I'm totally gonna have to film a spoiler warning at the beginning of this. It's like, we've spoiled the entire movie.
We have pretty much spoiled the entire Godzilla vs. Kong in this video.
Yeah.
And then theories, facts from King of Monsters, and just additional information the director has given us. All of which pretty much I've gotten from Wikizilla.
Of course.
Because that is just my main source of kaiju stuff.
Yeah. But honestly, I honestly think that either would be interesting, but I feel like the one that is would be more interesting, and the one that's more likely to happen, is the Kong movie. Because, like, Godzilla doesn't really have much set up at this point, right?
Well, there's what happened to Mechagodzilla, but besides that, not really, no.
Yeah. Well, like, Kong is living in the system that could have, like, all sorts of stuff.
He's living down in Hollow Earth, and an apparent leak for a movie, Son of Godzilla, Son of Kong, which I personally think makes zero sense because Kong is the last of his kind, so how would that even be possible? Has circulated, but I severely doubt that's going to actually end up being
And
a
even if it
movie.
is the case, that would be like the biggest spoiler title ever.
Yeah, because we know that means Kong is going to encounter another one of his species.
Yeah, like, it'd be like the title Ralph Breaks the Internet, like for that movie. Like the title spoils the entire
Yeah,
movie.
like if they hadn't had that in the title, we would just know from the trailers, oh, he's going on the internet.
Yeah.
No, he's gonna blow it up.
Yeah,
Thanks, title. We now know the essential main problem of the story.
good job. Anyway.
And the trailers also reveal why. Now we're talking about Ralph Breaks the
Yeah.
Internet.
Yeah,
Why
these
do we go off topic so easily?
Oh no.
It's extremely confusing.
Okay, so like basically we got the big five, right? We got the big five in Monsters finally. Like we got like King of Monsters had four of the big five, and then we have Mechagodzilla.
Yeah, so all of Toho's big five most popular monsters are now in the MonsterVerse,
Which is
which is pretty sweet. We have yet to get them all in the Reiwa era, though. We've
Reiwa.
got it's the era that has the Godzilla anime.
Oh.
Actually, no, apparently in the official prequel novels, we have got all of them, but technically we haven't seen Mothra besides a silhouette on film. We've gotten Godzilla, Ghidorah, and Mechagodzilla all in the Godzilla anime. Then we got Godzilla and Ghidorah again from the Shin Godzilla trilogy
Yeah.
and Godzilla vs. Evangelion, the real 4D. And then we got Rodan in Singular Point,
Yeah.
as well as Godzilla, but he hasn't become proper Godzilla
And like
yet.
hints to Mothra with Mothra Egg
Though that's in the end credits scene. That also has Kiryu with his head backwards and Manda fighting King Caesar.
Yeah, so
None of that is like probably official to the story. It's
yeah.
just the end credits is just endless hints and references to previous Godzilla movies.
Yeah, but like, I guess the singular point isn't over or
Well,
anything.
no, of course it's not over, because we know we're gonna get Godzilla Ultima, and currently Godzilla is only in his second form and hasn't reached Godzilla Ultima yet, which is the one we've seen in trailers.
Isn't it great that we have another Godzilla that's evolving like a freaking Pokemon?
Why is there always?
No, like Shin Godzilla and now Godzilla Ultima, which is like the biggest, like the most anime name for Godzilla ever.
Yeah.
So yeah.
Now we're running out of things to say.
We are running out of things to say. This is
This video's been like half an hour long, though, so I think this is a
yeah,
decent point to stop.
that's all for this time. Goodbye.
Bye.